Good evening. How's everybody?
Great.
Great?
Yes.
So tonight is our band aid concert. Before we get started with our phenomenal performance with our two great concert bands and Mr. Thompson and Mr. I and Mr. Miller, I'd like to tell you a little bit about what the band aid concerts are all about. Term band aid. Band aid, we're the band. We help a charity group that has personally touched our lives. So basically, every year we come up with a charity or foundation that we wish to support. And this year we chose the Gas Foundation. Over the last 20 years, or 10 years, we've been able to donate over $20,000 to different charities that have affected us. This year, the Gas Foundation, which stands for Games Adolescents Shouldn't Play, are here to tell us a little bit about the choking game, as well as awareness, what you should look out for, and exactly what they do as a charity. So all the way from Appleton, Wisconsin, today we have Mr. Kelly McCarthy, who's a representative from GASP, and also let's give a warm welcome to Officer Scott Matheny, who is here all the way from Pennsylvania. So Mr. Matheny.
Thank you. I thought I was hot in the lobby, but these lights don't make it any easier. Okay, my name is Scott McDavid. I'm a police officer in a suburb of Philadelphia, just like you are to Chicago. And I got involved with GASP, and GASP was formed back in 2005 when Kyle McCarthy died in Appleton. And I didn't know anything about the joking game until a few months before the organization started, when a couple parents asked me to educate their students about the joking game. And my first thought was, it's no real big deal. I haven't heard about it. How could it be that big of a problem? And I started doing some research, and I realized all of these kids that were dying across our country because they didn't have information they needed to make a good choice. And to me, that's what it boils down to. We have an educator of kids that this game is no game at all. It's an activity that you cannot win at. It's not that Josh did it wrong. It's that Josh did it because he did not. Because society didn't give him the information he needed to make a good choice. Whatever you get from this game, the rush, the getaway, is literally caused by brain cells dying off and giving a chemical release in an unnatural way. So for the kids behind me, the kids in the audience, you know, I want to give the message to you that there is no safe way to do this. Don't think that this is just a tragic thing because he went a little too far. Josh experimented with something that he didn't know how dangerous it was. And you can't win at this. And it was worth me coming from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania to tell you that. Because I tell communities all the time that they need to be proactive so that they don't have a death in their community. Unfortunately, your community can no longer be proactive. But you can be reactive. You can make sure that no other kid makes that same bad decision because they didn't know. Because nobody wanted to talk about it, because nobody wanted to give them an idea. Parents, I will tell you, the kids have the ideas. Go on YouTube and see what the kids are doing. And there's a lot more things going on, and the way to combat those things is to talk to your kids. And don't just say, don't do it because I said so. Give them reasons. Tell them why they shouldn't do it. Because if we don't explain why we don't want them to do it, they're just going to say, they're being old people. They don't like me. You've got to give them the reasons. Give them the excuses. Tell them what can happen. Look for wear marks on their bedposts or the closet rods from the ligatures they're using. Look for bruises on their neck or knots tied in the room that just don't seem right. Ask them the questions. Don't say, oh, I don't ask because God forbid what they might tell me. As a parent, you need to ask. That's your job. Your job is not to be their friend. And kids, you shouldn't think they need to be your friend. Their job is to be your parent. And that means making some tough decisions and giving them guidance. But ultimately, these decisions do belong to our kids. And we need to educate them so they can make the right decisions. GASP is an organization that is made to raise awareness. That is our primary goal. Matter of fact, I was just in Schaumburg last week. The state PTA conference contacted GASP and wanted a representative to speak at their conference, but they couldn't afford to have anybody come out and pay, or even pay the costs. Luckily, GASP had donations, and we had some other private donations that were made that was able to pay for me to come out and talk to that organization. So at least your state PTA started to get some information about what's going on, what's happening, and how to combat that. So I thank you for coming out tonight and supporting our organization. I'd like to let Kelly McCarthy speak a couple words again. His son Kyle died in 2005 again from just not having the information because nobody shared it back then. Nobody shares it now, at least not enough. So if you have questions at the end, we're going to be out there at the table. We have some informational flyers. We have some awareness kits that has a flash video. Normally we ask for a $50 donation for an awareness kit, but I was told tonight by our executive director, who's also here, that his company is going to fund any awareness kits that walk out the door. So if you need an awareness kit, take one. Okay, I'm going to let Kelly speak for a minute.
Thanks. It's hard for me to talk about this, and I don't want to take anything away from anything, just that the awareness starts with the parents, the students. You need to be aware of what's going on. You need to pass it on to everybody. You need to talk about it. Don't hide it. If your kids know somebody in playing that's doing it, you're not traveling. If you don't, that friend may not be here tomorrow. Thanks.
Thank you.
going to be introducing our guest conductor for the evening. This is a man who is very well-known and respected internationally, really, for his reputation as a high school band director. He is the retired director of bands from New Trier High School. Please welcome to the stage Mr. John Thompson.
Thank you.
thank you. For our second piece of the evening, we need another introduction for our conductor. At Schaumburg High School, we have a program for students who are interested in pursuing education as their major in college to come into the classroom at the high school level and kind of see behind the scenes what it's like and also get a chance to work with our students and try out education, basically. So we have two student interns this year, both of whom we will be seeing on this concert. So I'd like to introduce the first intern here who will be conducting the next piece for the cadet band. So please welcome Leanne Kesrilovic.
Thank you. the bass clarinet. The Cadet Band concludes with Fate of the Gods by Stephen Reinke. Fate of the Gods is a programmatic work for symphonic band inspired by tales of Nordic mythology. This piece tells the story of Ragnarok, also known as the Twilight of the Gods, an incredible war between forces of good and evil fought, bringing about the ends of the cosmos. After the destruction, a new and idyllic world will arise, and this new earth will be filled only with joy and abundance. As we perform this piece, we encourage you to follow along with the story, which will be projected on the back wall. Please enjoy Stephen Reinke's Fate of the Gods.
Thank you. Jordan Foyt, Kate Stanley. We are an all sophomore saxophone quartet. Today we'll be playing for you Airy Ballet from Alceste, which is by C.W. Van Vloog. We took this piece to IGSA State Ensemble Contest, and we received a Division I Superior rating. So please enjoy.
Thank you. my name is Vimal Patel, and I'm from the Planet. The concert band will continue with Fantasy for Band by Frank Erickson. The composer is well known for his setting of folk songs for concert. The Fantasy for Band was the composer's first expanded original work for band. The piece still features many folk elements, a signature of Frank Erickson's compositional style. Written in 1957, we present Fantasy for Band by Frank Erickson.
Thank you.
we're going to begin to wrap things up here for this evening. A few things that I want to mention. First off, we had one student who was playing with us today because another student in the percussion section couldn't be here, so he's filling in for us. We really appreciate it. And that is Chris Schiestel. So we'd like to thank you all again for coming out tonight, supporting the bands, and also supporting a great cause in the Gasp Foundation. Your generosity is greatly appreciated by the Gasp Foundation and everyone who is touched by the work that they do. Just so that you know, your money is actually going, it's kind of a two-for-one thing. We have a corporate sponsor who has pledged to match dollar for dollar any donations that we get over the next 2 days. So your money really is going to a great cause and helping a lot of people. So thank you again for coming and supporting the Gasp Foundation.
So again, Mr. Miller, thank you. Mr. Ryan, thank you for the invitation. Thank you.